What's your personal taste in cinema?
I have a whole plethora. The film that got me kind of like an out-of-body experience, making me want to make films, is Dr. Zhivago, because it encompasses the greatest love story I think ever told. It encompasses the whole revolution in Russia, the drama between the rich and the poor, and it's about a great poet. So that kind of cinema I love. And I love, you know, a whole plethora. Films that stay with me are always independent films that are made, powerful stories. They're the ones that when you come out, you keep with you and you go back to. And at the same time, I love going to a cinema and seeing a massive film like Avatar and Inception, these big Hollywood movies, which they do better than anyone else, the new ones, Batman. And they're getting darker. Funny enough, we were talking earlier about dark or light, but the American films are getting darker now. So my preference is that way anyway.
What is your method of judging Polish movie this year?
Purely on what captivates me. When the storytelling, basically, when the first thing is the emotions, the storytelling, and the way that it's told, and how it affects you emotionally, really, that's the core of what it is. So I look for that, because I expected the quality of filmmaking to be high, even when they're really low budget, and they are. It's they're very well made.
How the work of judges looks like? Like, I mean, you quarrel a lot, or your decision are like the same, or?
I was at Rabat Film Festival, the last one, and there were huge fights over the films, and we had one woman from Russia who was against everybody. She fought everybody, and the most obscure kind of strange film she was fighting for, and we were fighting for what we thought was the best filmmaking. So in the end, though, you put in your votes, and you all, it's whichever one gets the most votes, because it has to be a democratic procedure. So, and I noticed, like in Rabat, there was a lot of influencing of jury members, and there, different to here, which is more interesting, there we were forced to watch the films together in the cinema, go to lunch together, so we were talking about it all the time, and there was a lot of manipulating, like politics. Here, no, we're seeing the film separately, which I think is more interesting, so we'll all come in with our own views on it, and then it's going to be interesting to see that morning when we all get together which and how those decisions are made. But I know there are lots, there's often fighting going on.
You are a world-known set designer. What you can say about Polish set designs in the movies that you saw on this festival?
Well, they're all, when I did a workshop here, and the main mantra I was saying to everybody was, to me, and it has to look real, and the major thing about art directing and production designing is they're called unsung heroes, because the better it is, the less it's seen. Even if it's a massive period film, you don't notice it because it's there, so that's the most success. So all of the films were correctly kind of environments, and I explained to them, if people can make films on their iPhones now, and you're alone, you're doing it alone, but if you set it in a room like this and you're doing a punk film that's about a violent situation, this wouldn't be the best place to set it. So all of the ones I saw were very good, and you have Starsky is a world known production designer, obviously. And I think there's a tradition here anyway of understanding it, which is often the hardest thing, is to get people to understand how that fuses into the film.
And tomorrow you will introduce your new project that you will be making in Poland. Can you say something about it?
Well, Wojciech Palace is the producer here. I met him about 4 years ago. I was here. They'd asked me to come and direct a project, which we didn't make at the end of the day, but I spend a lot of time here, and Wojciech and I became like brothers on that project. It was a difficult situation, and we tried to produce a film for another very big American or British director, Roland Joffé, and he couldn't get together what we needed to make the film, but I spent a lot of time with him, And at that stage, he grilled me incessantly on international cinema. How did it work? How does it work with sales agents? How does it work with bonds? All of these things. So I gave him a kind of masterclass over a few months. So he called me up and said, you know, I'm now in a position, I've changed so much and I've had a hit film here. We can make a film here. Can you come up with a project? And then one day I kind of tentatively sent him an email and said, you know, one of my favorite writers of all time is your kind of Polish national hero, is Stanisław Lem. And he's the father of intellectual science fiction, which I like. One of the books that I've always loved, and then I thought this is really appropriate because it is set all in America, is Memories in a Bathtub. And so I approached it with Wojciech, and he said, this is a great idea. There's a few master writers in the world, and Len is one, and they're always prophetic about the world. And he obviously wrote this at a time when he wasn't allowed to write what he wanted to say, so he set it in America. And the most interesting thing for me now is the reversal in the world that's happening. And America is becoming more and more isolated, more and more suspicious as a country. And in fact, Lem would never have known this, but it was completely prophetic about the modern world. So this is deeply interesting to me, and it's an amazing drama. It'll be an epic film, and it certainly has huge international appeal. If Lem wrote the book today, it would be a different book to what he wrote then, for sure, because his eyes are different, and the world, since he wrote it, has changed radically. One of the major things is that in his time then, women were making coffee and polishing their nails and not allowed to do anything. Now, since then, we have women presidents, women prime ministers, women secretaries of state. And Lem's son agreed with this. It was the thing we were most nervous about, whether we could put women. And he asked me, can you please put women in the film? Because it's essential. Because the there has to be a story involving a woman within this city, because that makes the emotions work much better for the story and for the agent. I had the privilege of going to Lem's house and sitting with his son for 2 hours and discussing a great deal about this. And we had to be blessed by him for us to make the film, because his father's work is obviously very sacrosanct. The film is set underground in America, and we have the most incredible locations here in Wieniawska and some others. So that's all, I call it serendipity, it all came together very quickly.
Bardzo mi w pewnym momencie zależało, żeby przekonać i mojego partnera, i naszych przyjaciół, prawda, z grupy kreatywnej, żebyśmy stworzyli film o tyle, o ile to jest możliwe, rdzennie polski, z naprawdę istotną szansą na dystrybucję międzynarodową. Teraz jakbyśmy to mogli tak przez sekundę rozebrać, mianowicie co znaczy film istotnie pro-polski. Po pierwsze, genialny polski pisarz, świetni polscy twórcy, reżyser, w tym wypadku Anglik, ale z ogromnym doświadczeniem, zwłaszcza w takim gatunku kina.
Zostałem zaproszony do tej pracy przez Wojtka Paulusa. Zadzwonił do mnie, ja wiem kiedy to był Wojtek, z miesiąc temu, tak. I mówi, słuchaj, jest taka sprawa, jest taka książka Pamiętnik znaleziony we mnie Lema. Ja mówię, świetnie, tak, tam czytałem go jako nastolatek, bardzo mi się podobała. Jeszcze wtedy trwały czasy komuny, oczywiście wszędzie widziałem komuny i wszędzie widziałem aluzję do komuny. Co mnie urzekło w tej książce? Przede wszystkim ja bardzo lubię człowieka pod presją, człowieka pod ścianą, człowieka, który jest przygniatany ze wszystkich stron i tak dokładnie nie jest w stanie sobie zdać sprawy, co go tak gryzie, co go gnębi. I Lem daje tutaj niesamowite pokłady, zarówno jeżeli chodzi o fabułę jako story, tak? Czyli bohatera, który znajduje się nagle w jakimś wielkim gmachu podziemnym, gdzie trwa jakaś wojna, jest agentem, ma do wypełnienia pewną misję, ale tej misji sam nie zna. I sam zaczyna się zastanawiać, czy przypadkiem on nie jest narzędziem kogoś i czy sam nie jest przypadkiem wkręcony w jakąś czyjąś misję. To jest jedna podstawowa warstwa. Natomiast druga warstwa jest filozoficzna. To jest taka warstwa, w której Lem zadaje takie podstawowe pytania od zadawane właściwie od samego początku istnienia naszej kultury, naszej cywilizacji, to jest, czy nasza karta, czy kartka, z którą się rodzimy, jest pusta, czy też ta kartka jest zapisana, czy mamy do wypełnienia pewien cel, pewną drogę do przejścia w naszym życiu już od narodzin, czy nie.
W tym tygodniu także dołączył do nas kompozytor pochodzący z Krakowa, Abel Korzeniowski. Także to jest ten główny zespół twórców. Ten film planujemy zrobić w sposób realistyczny, to znaczy nie myślimy o jakichkolwiek hollywoodzkich budżetach. Ja myślę, że w zależności od finalnych stawek aktorskich budżet powinien oscylować w rejonach 3 milionów euro. Wszystko wskazuje na to, że najpóźniej będziemy kręcić film w pierwszym kwartale przyszłego roku. Oczywiście będziemy starać się o wsparcie Polskiego Instytutu, ale co do zasady, no Polski Instytut wspiera, prawda, produkcję, a owe wsparcie nie polega na tym, że wokół tego wsparcia się buduje. To znaczy my musimy sobie sami poradzić ze zbudowaniem filmu, ze zbudowaniem kręgosłupa, który już no, w istotnych częściach mamy, jak to się mówi, in place. I myślę, że w najbliższych miesiącach będziemy absolutnie gotowi, żeby w sposób właściwy, z wszystkimi wiążącymi informacjami, stosowne aplikacje wysłać do Instytutu.